Hey, thanks for joining us. For those of you watching us on YouTube and on Facebook, glad you could join us today. Ukraine and Russia believe progress is made in the ongoing peace talks. That's despite Moscow's latest airstrike sparking fears of the conflict spilling over to neighboring countries. Here's the full story.
A Russian airstrike hit a large military base in western Ukraine on Sunday, extending the conflict into new areas. At least 35 people died and more than 130 were wounded, according to regional governor Maxim Kozitsky. He said Russian planes fired around 30 rockets at the facility, but some were intercepted. Reuters was unable to verify his statement. Britain said the incident at the extensive Yavoriv base, just 15 miles from the border with NATO member Poland, marked a significant escalation. It also heightens fears that Russia's invasion of Ukraine could spill over into neighboring NATO member states. US President Joe Biden has previously said NATO would defend every inch of its territory if that happened. Intensive Russian attacks have been reported around the country. In Cherniv, around 100 miles northeast of Kyiv, firefighters rescued residents from a burning building after heavy shelling, verified video from Ukraine's emergency services showed. Moscow denies targeting civilians. Ukraine also reported renewed airstrikes on an airport in the west and attacks on the southern town of Mykolaiv, where officials said 9 people were killed. Ukraine's Human Rights Monitor said Russia used phosphorus bombs in an overnight attack on the town of Popasna in the eastern Luhansk region. Reuters has not verified those reports. In the southern port city of Kherson, more than 400 people were detained by Russia's National Guard as they protested against Russia's occupation of the area, according to Ukraine's military high command. Despite the violence, both Russia and Ukraine said they thought progress could be made at peace talks, 18 days after Moscow launched what it calls a special military operation. A Ukrainian delegate said Russia was beginning to, quote, talk constructively, and results were possible in a matter of days. A Russian delegate also said they'd made significant progress.
A message of hope and defiance from Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky on day 18 of the Russian invasion. He says despite the airstrike in western Ukraine and the evacuation of thousands of civilians from across the country, Ukraine will win because his people know how to unite. Zelensky repeated his call to NATO to implement a no-fly zone over Ukraine. He also expressed optimism in the ongoing peace talks and a possible meeting with Russian counterpart Vladimir Putin.
I also visited checkpoints today. I didn't want it to be very public, just to support our guys. They are courageous men, cheerful guys, who defend Kyiv and know that we will win. You can feel it. We will win thanks to our unique ability to unite our people. We can always care for our people, ours by spirit, ours in their hearts, in their sincerity. Now about negotiations with the Russian Federation, our delegation has a clear task to do everything possible to ensure that the meeting of the presidents takes place, a meeting that I'm sure people expect. Obviously, this is a complicated situation. It's a difficult path, but a necessary path. And our goal is to ensure that Ukraine gets the necessary result from this struggle, from this difficult negotiation work. It is necessary for us, for peace and for security.
An American journalist is killed while another is wounded after being fired upon by Russian forces in Ukraine's Kyiv region. The deceased was identified as Brent Renaud. He had previously worked for the New York Times. The injured journalist, Juan Arredondo, was able to give an account of the attack before being taken into surgery.
We crossed the first bridge in Nirpin. We're going to film other refugees leaving, and we got into a car. Somebody offered to take us to the other bridge, and we crossed a checkpoint, and they start shooting at us. So the driver turned around, and they kept shooting. It's two of us. My friend is Brent Renaud, and he's been shot and left behind.
And how is he?
I don't know.
You don't know what happened to him?
I saw him being shot in the neck, and we got split, and I got pulled into the...
And who brought you here?
An ambulance, I don't know.